earlier choice for late local news. This is Q13, Fox News at 9 on MyQ2.
Only on Q13 Fox News tonight, they came for coffee, but got quite a show. And the camera catches a local bikini barista bearing it all. The lewd behavior launched a police investigation. Now, five local women are facing prostitution charges.
Let's get right to Q13 Fox News reporter James Lynch, who has been following this story all day, James.
Unbelievable, Maria. This is the culmination of a two-month investigation by the Everett Police Department. They probably don't know it yet because the findings came late this evening. But five Grab&Go baristas working within the city of Everett are now charged with multiple counts of prostitution and multiple violations of the city's adult entertainment ordinance.
It was behavior like this, witnessed by Everett investigators, that led to today's charges. Police say it happened here at the Grab&Go Bikini Coffee Hut in the 8,000 block of Broadway. As we watched this evening, cars, one after another, pulled in and pulled out. Neighbors say traffic here lasts all day and all night. We shot this video from a nearby home, and the homeowner says she's been shocked at what she sees. She chose not to go on camera.
They spread their underwear and then they're shots.
The video you see here was shot at a different Grab&Go Bikini Hut on Highway 99 in Snohomish County, just outside Everett. None of the girls here have been charged, but this video shows the conduct with some of them is the same. After the driver ordered coffee and paid, the barista held up the change, about $16, and asked if he wanted something extra. When he asked what, she says, a flash, and proceeded to drop her bottom, splash her vagina, then turn around, spread her cheeks, and flash her rear. Then she turned around again and flashed her vagina.
For extra money, these women would expose their entire body. They would take, if they were wearing a bikini, they would either take it off or at least lower it. There were some allegations, complaints from our citizens that they were performing whipped cream shows between two of the women.
As for the prostitution charges, police say there doesn't appear to have been actual intercourse. Instead, the sexual conduct, as defined by the Everett Municipal Code, included any touching of the sexual and other intimate parts of a person. This woman, who again was not charged, says not all of the baristas break the law.
Now, we talked to the owner of Grab&Go Espresso. He says he hasn't seen the police report, but gave us a statement about his company policy. Bill Wheeler says the girls sign a policy which is strictly enforced, and any violation or illegal activity means they're immediately fired. Wheeler says every girl who works for him knows what attire is acceptable for work. The girls must cover their bottoms and use pasties if necessary. He says the policy also makes it clear that the girls may not use whipped cream on their bodies and that no sexual gestures are allowed. Wheeler, at this time, Maria, doesn't face city charges at all.
So how serious are these charges, though, that the girls are facing?
Well, they're municipal charges within the city of Everett. They are punishable by 90 days in jail and up to a $1,000 fine. It is important to note, I think, that a lot of other of these bikini barista huts have allegations that have been lodged against them of similar activity. But I guess we can only assume that there hadn't been as many complaints against those as the police say that they've had against Grab&Go, which led to their investigation.
James, thank you. And of course, the Everett Herald has also been working on this story today, and you can read more in tomorrow morning's paper. And you can go to our website for more information as well as video. Go to Q13Fox.com. David?